Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Welcome back to another episode of Breakfast with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam where we learn about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam every morning from the kitab Khulasah Nurul Yakin. And what I like about this book is that it teaches us about the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam chronologically in four short points. Now, in our previous episode, we learn about the Quraysh marching to the uncle of Rasulullah SAW, Abu Talib, and asking from him to prevent Rasulullah SAW from doing da'wah. Right? Okay. So, in this episode, we are going to learn about them going to Abu Talib for the second time. Now, let's go to the lesson. Okay, before we start the lesson, okay, if you are watching on YouTube, please subscribe to Aspire Institute TV and like the video and turn on that notification, right? So if you're watching outside of YouTube, please visit aspireinstitute.com and aspireinstitute.tv. Okay, now lesson 19, the Quraysh coming to Abu Talib for the second time. Maji'u Quraishin li Abi Talibin marratan thaniyah. Lamma ra'at Quraishun istimraran Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam fi nashri da'watih wa difa'i 'ammihi anhu, mashaw ila 'ammihi marratan thaniyah. Lesson 19, the Quraysh coming to Abu Talib for the second time. When the Quraysh saw that Prophet peace be upon him continue spreading his da'wah and his uncle defending him, they march to him for the second time. March to who? March to Abu Talib, the uncle of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the father of Ali bin Abi Talib. Point number 2. Waqalu lahu inna la nasbiru ala shatmi abaina wa tasfihi uqulina wa aibi alihatina fa imma an tamna abna akhik wa imma an ta'dhana lana liman'i. And they told him, we really can no longer be patient when our forefathers are being ridiculed and our minds are considered foolish and our gods being criticized. Okay, so this is what they feel when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam doing his da'wah openly. And so they continue, either you prevent the son of your brother or you permit us to prevent him, means prevent or stop Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from doing his da'wah works. Fada'ahu ammuhu wa talaba minhu an yamtani' khawfan 'alayhi min Quraysh fa abar rasul. And so his uncle called him and asked him to stop for fearing for his safety from the Quraysh, but Rasulullah peace be upon him disregard. So why did his uncle ask him to stop? Of course, if you love someone, you will worry about his safety when other people threaten. So when the Quraysh come to Abu Talib for the second time, Abu Talib look at it as a threat, right? So if Rasulullah SAW continue, maybe his life continue doing da'wah, right? His life may be in danger. Right, the Quraysh may try to harm him. So this is the reason why Abu Talib want Rasulullah SAW to stop. As we have learned in the previous lessons also, Abu Talib really love Rasulullah SAW. وَقَالَ وَاللَّهِ لَا أَتْرُكُ هَذَا الْأَمْرِ حَتَّى يُظْهِرَهُ اللَّهُ أَوْ أَهْلِكَ دُونَهُ. Okay, so Rasulullah disregard Abu Talib's advice, and the reason is because Rasulullah really believe in Islam and it is the truth. And Rasulullah said, look at it as a gift to mankind, to the entire universe, right? To the whole world. So Rasulullah want everyone to know about Islam. So Rasulullah said, by Allah, I will not leave this matter. Means I will not stop. I will not quit until Allah made it clear. Meaning Allah made it such that everyone knows about Islam, right? Means I want to fulfill my duty, or I rather perish without it. Meaning if I'd rather die lah than stop. Okay, that is how determined Rasulullah SAW. So this lesson is about determination, strong will of Rasulullah SAW, something that we should emulate, okay, in our life. You know, if we want success, we need to have that drive, that strong will to be successful, to be able to achieve what we aspire to achieve. Point number 5, فَقَالَ لَهُ عَمُّهُ اِذْهَبْ وَقُلْ مَا أَحْبَبْتَ فَوَاللَّهِ لَا أُسْلِمُكَ أَبَدًا. And so his uncle told him, go and say what you wish. By Allah, I will never surrender you ever. So look what happened. When you believe in yourself and you believe in what you are doing, it is infectious. Okay, other people will also believe in you, but you yourself must have a very strong belief. So this is where we see that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's faith and belief is so strong that it influences Abu Talib to believe in him. And Abu Talib say that, okay, go ahead and do what you want to do, right? And say what you want to say. We will never surrender you. In other words, that also mean we will support you, right? Okay, by keeping you safe. Alright, as'ila. Questions. لماذا مشت قريش لأبي طالب في المرة الثانية? Why did Quraysh march to Abu Talib the second time? ماذا قالوا له? What did they tell him? هل منعه عمه? Did his uncle prevent him, try to stop him? Bimaza ajab ar-rasul? Okay, what did Rasulullah reply? Bimaza ajabahu ammuhu? What did his uncle reply? Al-khulasa, summary. Mashat Quraishun ila ammihi marratan thaniyah liyamna'ahu min sabbi alihatihim falam yastati'u an yamna'uhu wa madha fi sabili. Summary, Quraysh marched to his uncle Abu Talib the second time, asking him to prevent Rasulullah from criticizing their gods. And they failed to prevent him. And Rasulullah still continue on his path. So, thank you very much for watching this episode of Breakfast with Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Right, I hope you have been benefiting from this episode. Right, we are learning about Rasulullah from the time he was born until now that he has become the messenger of Allah and preaching openly. Right, so if you have not watched the previous episodes, you know, please go to our channel Aspire Institute TV, subscribe and look at the season 1 of Breakfast with Rasulullah ﷺ playlist. Thank you so much for watching. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.